Alright, remove the drain channel rear, pushing the button, take it out. Remove drain channel front, flathead screwdriver between the parts. Take it out on both sides. Remove the glass panel motor front first. Remove all three attachment points by bending up the clips and take the lower rail out. Use a flathead screwdriver to push on the drive cable plate with the flathead screwdriver into the holes. Push the mechanism back 2 or 3 inches until you open up on the front a little bit better. Take a flathead screwdriver and remove the arm of the front mechanism. Same screwdriver. Now move the drive cable plate back all the way forward until the arm comes all the way up. Then you can remove very easy the whole complete arm. Lift up the lock from the front glass panel mechanic and move the mechanic a little bit backwards until the wedge comes out. Remove that wedge up and then sideways out of the hole. Now slide the whole mechanic back out of the track. Now remove the extra slider all the way out of the track on the rear end. Now remove with a flathead screwdriver the glass panel drive cable out of the guide by pushing it backwards. Now remove the rear glass panel mechanic out of the guide by pushing it sideways with a flathead screwdriver and lift it out and slide them out. Now remove the support drain channel rear out of the guide by breaking off the clips and lift it up, guide them out, remove all the small parts out of the track. Then remove the part below the rear glass panel mechanic by breaking that tab off. Cover your eyes. Now unlock the rear glass panel mechanic and push it backwards. Until the rear piece is fully visible, then you take a flathead screwdriver, push it out sideways,
okay.
Move it sideways out of the track. Now keep pushing backwards, make sure it stays unlocked. It can lock in several times until the drive cable comes out. Pull on the drive cable while pushing so all the parts can be taken out. Sideways again, out of the track. Now, pull the drive cable all the way out. Now remove the pivot point wind deflector, take the screwdriver, unclip it, unhook it. Take it out. Now remove that fixation point so it's able to slide backwards. Now slide the whole thing backwards out of the track. You will see there's an end, which is the drive cable. Sunshade will stop you pushing that part all the way out. That means you have to remove the drive cable sunshade out of the track. Best way, take two screws out from the drive cable, cover plate rear or cross member rear, push on that wedge until the drive cable comes out in the side. Now remove the drive cable ends out of the track, the lower track. Then you are able to slide the piece out of the guide. Clean up the complete guide with a brush of all debris, dust and dirt. Increase it nicely to make sure it's working properly for the installation. Now install the new part into the guide by pushing it in on the bottom and all the way forward. Push these clips into position all the way down until it's clipped in and snapped in all the way. Now install the new pivot point wind deflector onto the wind deflector and put them into the right position. Push it down and sideways out until it clips all the way in. Now slide that wedge forward, push the wind deflector down, inside, underneath and let it go. Now install the sunshade drive cable back into the lower hole of the guide and screw them back down. Install first the short drive cable. As you can see, there's a cutout here and a little pin in here, so they come together. Install first the drive cable, line up the wedge with the drive cable cutout, push them all the way in. Unlock it, slide it forward, keep it unlocked. Then use this part, line them up again, install on the rear end on the drive cable, and push both all the way forward and not visible anymore on the side. Now, these two parts, we leave them out until the end, so we don't need to use a second kit just in case you made a mistake. Now install the new drive cable into the right channel with that piece in the front. Push them all the way in. Keep pushing. Now align this one here underneath the guide. Make sure that only the pin is above. And then push it forward into the guide. Use again flathead screwdriver into the cover plate holes. Screw in. Keep pushing. It will unlock that piece. And you keep pushing until you hit the end or the beginning of the pivot point wind deflector. Now install this one into the drive cable plate, straight up into the hole, all the way in, lay it down a little bit, then take this piece, slide them all the way in from the rear end, now take these two pieces, put them together and put them in the rear end, slide them in, lift up the lock, push the whole part forward, now put that part all the way down. Keep pushing forward until that lock is all the way down and locked in. It cannot be up, it has to be all the way down, locked in. Now install the retraction bar into the arm. Hold it that way. Install the end of the retraction bar into that hole and lay it down. The lock on the other side and move that whole mechanic a little bit backwards, like half an inch, until this piece can go underneath. Now push the whole mechanic back forward until it's back locked in. Only push both all parts back, slide them all the way back until you have your opening back in the front. Put in first the outside piece, bend a little bit backwards to get the inside in and underneath. Now push the on the drive cable plate again forward half forward. Use a small screwdriver, push it through the hole on the drive cable plate, push it back until this piece hits that screwdriver. That is the setup for the timing. You have to do this on both sides in the same way.
Three.
Use a small pliers, bend both little, all three little tips a little bit back out, because you bend them back in before, you have to bend them back out. Install. Pushing it down, has the lock in nice and strong. Line them up on the Uri end. Push them down all the way until you lock in. Push them down in the middle. And make sure they're strong inside and don't come out again. If you follow all the instructions, the drive cable should be still fine, not broken. No pin broken, everything should be perfectly correct. Now is the time to put the clips in, because these parts cannot be reused. Install that in a kind of sideways angle, as installs easier. Put them all the way down in position. And make sure the clips are both in. Now, install the support range and rear. Push them in the same way until it's all the way down and clipped in. Screwdriver. Now install the rear clasp and the mechanic. Slide them onto the triangle piece. Line them up with the piece you just installed. Push to the outside and the front end. And push down all the way until it's all the way down and parallel. Now push them a little bit back in. Then you're done.
True.
Now install the front drain channel back into place. Put in the spring from the outside. Now install the front drain channel. Put the spring inside. Lay down a little bit the front drain channel. Then you can push down. Make sure it's working all the way down properly.